this is St. Rose. Nice place, huh? Okay, let's talk. This year has been nuts. I mean, wow. So many things getting canceled and changed and blah, blah, blah. But guess what? Christmas isn't canceled. No way. Here at St. Rose, we're gearing up for a fantastic Advent season and a Christmas filled with community spirit. Let's start with Thanksgiving. Remember the turkey drive? It's on. This year, it's a basket donation. You can drop off a bag of groceries on Saturday, November 21st, or just go to the website and click to donate. So simple. How about the wreath sale? Newsflash, it is so happening. Support Troop 17. They'll even deliver it to your house. Don't let your house be the only one without a wreath this year. And how about the Giving Tree? Oh, I love the Giving Tree. The Giving Tree will be right here, as it always is, starting mid-November. Take a card and buy a kid something to make Christmas wonderful. Because that's what we're all about, right? And how about Coats for Kids? Guess what? It's on. Here's the link. Magic. And while you're at it, get yourself a warm hat. Because we're going to be doing outdoor masses straight through the end of the year. Will it be cold? Yeah, probably. But if you've ever been to a football game in November, you got this. For the full Christmas schedule, check out stroseshorthills.org or call the parish office. 2020's been tough, but let's finish strong, St. Rose. Stay engaged, get involved, and Merry Christmas.
Let us all rejoice in the Lord as we celebrate the feast in honor of all the saints, at whose festival the angels rejoice and praise the Son of God. Let us praise God singing from your online worship aid for all the saints.
Sin and come into your presence to receive your whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you, for which we so earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the far east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen. Blessings and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Oh Lord, this is a peace.
reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Today is a great day for the church, for it is the feast day of all of us. All of us, the great and famous ones, Elizabeth and Zechariah, Dominic and Teresa, Andre and Carlo, Michael and Margaret. Also, it's the feast of our relatives and friends who have gone before us, whom we know see God now face to face, who were baptized in the name of Jesus and now share the fullness of his life and glory. The grandmother whose holiness was in welcoming, our uncle whose support was always there, A friend whose advice could always be counted on, a neighbor who always made time to collect food for the hungry. So today is the day to celebrate. Parents and grandparents, sisters and brothers, neighbors and cousins, friends, people we might not even know, but for their good deeds. Today, the lesson is clear on All Saints' Day. We have friends in high places. Who are the people that we honor today? We honor those who love Jesus and put their trust in him as they journeyed through this life. We look to them today for their example, and we want them to pray for us. Who are these people? They are the ones who, by their living, became role models for us. They taught us about forgiveness. They exemplified caring for the poor and the suffering. Who are these people, these saints? They are the mediators. They are the ones between God and ourselves. They are the ones who stand with Jesus to remind him of our needs. They are like a bridge for us. The saints are the ones who speak our name to Jesus, and they strengthen our prayers as they ascend before our Father's throne. This weekend, nature reminds us that it's changing very quickly to prepare for winter. We might tell ourselves today, this All Saints Day, the day after Halloween, the eve of All Saints, that a saint could almost be compared to a pumpkin. Like the farmer who picks the pumpkin up from the field, he carries it in and washes it. The farmer cuts the top and cleans out all the yucky stuff inside. He gives the pumpkin a new face and places within it, a special light. So the Lord chooses us, he carries us, he forgives us and cleans us, he gives us a new face and a new life. He places within us the light of the Holy Spirit. And so the saint is likened to a pumpkin, a light in the darkness of this world. The saint is the one who lives the Beatitudes. The saint is the one who is a person of mercy and peace. The saint is one who hungers and works for justice. The saint is the one who joins with people of every race and language and rejoices in Christ's presence. The saint is the one who looks to be in the world a light for others, that the words and truth of Jesus will lead us to be like them. Saints, fully alive. Saints, now, today, and forever. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Out of his great love for us, God has made us children of light in communion with the saints, and so we pray together.
That our Pope Francis and all the leaders of the Church may instruct and inspire God's people on the way to holiness, we pray to the Lord. That the meek and those who hunger and thirst for righteousness may know the strength of God's love and the fullness of God's power, we pray to the Lord. That the merciful and clean of heart may experience the depth of God's forgiveness and the height of God's goodness, we pray to the Lord. That the poor in spirit and those who mourn may receive the riches of God's glory and the joy of God's life, we pray to the Lord. That all of our parishioners may one day join all the saints in the praise of God's honor and glory, we pray to the Lord. That all who have died may know the peace of the heavenly kingdom in the company of the angels and saints, especially for our recently deceased Joe Bibbo, Joseph Shepherd III, Teresa Ryan, Paul W. Thomas, and Joseph Kennedy. May we pray to the Lord. For all those we have promised to pray for, and for all the intentions we hold in our hearts, for all those who have been infected by the coronavirus, may God inspire wisdom and perseverance for all who work developing therapies and a vaccine. We pray to the Lord.
Ever-living God, we are gathered as your family to praise your name and honor your holy ones. In your kindness, hear and answer our prayers. Let us share their communion of life and love forever and ever.
As our gifts are presented and prepared this morning, we sing once again from your online worship aid, Ye Watchers and Ye Holy Ones.
Ye watchers and ye holy ones.
offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so may we experience their concern for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her we eagerly hasten, as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church, through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that these may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, gave it to his disciples saying, take this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and saints, Rose of Lima, and all those who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but look upon the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of his peace. The Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called now to the supper of the Lamb.
As we come to the table of the Lord this week, we sing, We are the light of the world.
Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly homeland through Christ our Lord. And please pay attention to this announcement for details on our annual upcoming Thanksgiving food drive. As in past years, we ask our parishioners to donate a Thanksgiving dinner for a needy family in Essex or Union County. Last year, we were able to help over 300 families in need. And with the COVID virus this year having so many people out of work, there is even more demand for our assistance. There are bags at the church doors with a list of needed items available after each Mass, which will be collected on Saturday, November 21st, in the parking lot between 9 and 10 a.m. If you are unable to get to the store to purchase the items, you can now donate a food basket through our website, www.stroseshorthills.org. So don't forget, Saturday, November 21st, in the parking lot, the food drop-off from 9 to 10 a.m. with the bags now at the doors of the church. Thanks very much for your help in this important effort. We'd also like to bring to your attention that tomorrow, Monday at 7:30 a.m. and 7:30 p.m., November 2nd, there will be on HTTV the Memorial Mass for All Souls Day, 7:30 in the morning and 7:30 at night. On HTTV, there will be our Memorial Mass. And we invite everyone to please participate in that event. Thank you. Bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. May God, the glory and joy of the saints, who has caused you to be strengthened by means of their outstanding prayers, bless you with unending blessings. Amen. And may the blessing and the peace of God be always in your hearts, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
We go forth singing, by all your saints still striving.